Hey guys, I'm Shasta, your host of Shasta Steam Journal, and today I'll be interviewing Sherry Roush and Cliff Edson about the Delta classes that Calaveras County will be offering this fall, and just kind of the process and decisions behind everything that's going on with it, and just kind of the plan for the next couple of years. And it's going to be really nice to hear everything that they're working on and the behind the scenes of everything. And let's go ahead and introduce you guys. So this is Sherry.
Hi.
This is Cliff. And
hello.
Just go ahead and explain to us kind of what's your position in this county. Obviously, you're a board of supervisor. What about you, Sherry?
I have just been hired with Delta College to be the Calaveras liaison. So I will be employed with them to try and help to build the secondary college here in Calaveras.
And when did you come up with the decision of thinking that offering classes here in Calaveras County would be a good idea?
We've been working with them for 10 years, trying really hard to get classes here. And we've kind of gone back and forth, and there's been a large committee working, and Delta now has a new president, Kathy Hart, and so she was very willing to sit down and work with us, so we're very excited.
That's awesome. I can't wait to see you guys, what you guys have in store for us. And what about you? So what's your decision behind doing the classes? I know you talked about, you know, keeping families here in Calaveras County and everything.
Yeah, there's a couple of things. One is, you know, we pay Delta College about $1.6 million a year. This year we did anyhow, from our property taxes and a bond measure. When I came into office, I noticed that they weren't having any classes up here. And I thought, sure, would like to see a return on investment. Yeah. So, you know, we have been in about 20 years or 25 years of exporting our youngest, our brightest students to out of county to get educated. They stay there. They become part of somebody else's economy, and we lose out. And by the way, we pay for that. Mm-hmm. So, thought it'd be a good idea to jump on board. I know Sherry and a few people were working on it for a long time. And so we got a committee together, and here we are.
Why exactly did we choose Delta in the first place?
We are part of their district and have been since the 60s, I believe it was, the 60s.
Yeah, about 1963.
Mm-hmm.
We joined their district in the 70s, but the California state made a law in the state of California that every parcel, every piece of property will be part of a college district, and they will pay. So I'm not quite sure when Delta came into the district, but here we are, so.
Mm-hmm. Sherry, give me some main points of Delta's history that you would like to cover.
You know, they've been around a long time. They have they started out with the Stockton campus, and now they have a Mountain House campus, and they have a lot of outreach campuses. And they have a rich history teaching as a junior college. And I think it hasn't been that long ago, they celebrated their 50 years. Mm-hmm. So it's you know, they have a lot of stability, and they have a lot to offer.
That's good to hear. What classes will we be offering this fall?
Well, this fall, we're actually going to be offering computer science, English 1A, English 79, which is a preparatory English, and political science. And we're going to be working with them doing more enrichment type, culinary, fire science, more a vocational type, nursing. And Calaveras is rich in a lot of different areas that we have buildings, we have people, we have a lot of stuff we have to offer. So just kind of really being able to do certification type programs.
And these classes will be in Calaveras High School, right? Like that's where they're going to be taking place?
Some. So okay. The academic classes will be at Calaveras.
Okay.
We're in the process of trying to make part of the library, a learning center for online courses. So Delta has said that they'll purchase computers for dedicated online classes. And the vocational, you know, wherever we can find a spot. At the high school, they have a automotive shop that they teach. So we can do automotive tech. And I believe that Delta has offered to do automotive tech in the spring at the high school. I'd like to see wastewater management, freshwater management, fire science. We have a hospital that has agreed to let us use their classes.
That's awesome.
So, you know, we have a lot of resources up here that we can make available. Mm-hmm. And Sherry here gets a responsibility of building that, you know, the program. So yeah. I'm really excited about that part.
How long do you think it's going to take for the proper things to be provided for the library to start having classes there?
I hope not long. So I think after this first round, I really would like to tell people that we really need to fill those classes. So if you need to take them, you would like to take them, you would like to be a part, it would be a great start if we can get those classes filled. And we can then move into, you know, start then enriching and doing other things. My job as the liaison is just to talk to everybody, get all the ideas. Mm-hmm. I have to find teachers who are qualified to teach. I need to fill the classes with students who are wanting to take it and to really find and get the pulse of the community and find the need.
And what is the enrollment process like for these people that would like to enroll in these classes?
Well, they need to enroll at Delta. So I believe at the end of this, there'll be the website and there's a phone number. So they do need to enroll. We have been told by the president that Calaveras will be handled with kid gloves, and they will make sure that we get the classes that we need up here, and I'm very excited about that.
That's really, really good to hear.
And Delta also said that they want to collaborate with Columbia, which means that right now, if you took like English 1A here, and you needed a couple of more classes for, you know, on your general ed, mm-hmm. you might have to go to Delta. But what Sherry is going to try to do is try to make it to where Columbia will offer the complimentary classes for that general ed there, and then they can go back and forth between, we're hopeful, to go back and forth between here and Angels Camp only to be able to do that, get their general ed. Within 3 years, they have said that they would like to do 24 units here, which means you can get your AA or your AS degree.
Mm-hmm. Wow, there's so much going on with whole process and the decisions behind it. I mean, it's really going to affect our community in positive ways. Yeah. And you are actually going to be taking a computer class, right?
Zach? Yeah, I've committed to it.
Are you excited for it?
Well, you know, I'm not really a tech guy, so.
But you know what? Basic, you know, computer skills and everything is really, really important for this day and age. It really, really is. I mean, 15-year-olds and even my little sister that's 9, she's like pro at the computer. So, yeah, you need to jump on board with that.
Yeah, I got to beat your little sister, that's for sure. But my wife has also said that she would take it, so we'll be in the class together probably.
That's good. Tag-team it. Yeah. That's a good idea, good idea. Okay, you guys, so what exactly are some problems that you guys see, you know, coming along during this journey? What are some problems do you think that you guys might run into during this whole process?
You want to take that one?
You know, I think that it's just, it's a mindset, and so it's kind of, you know, there's a lot of hurt feelings because of the past and because we have paid so much money to Delta. So it's just, it's the mindset of getting people to say, let's give it a try and see if it works. So it's being able to sit down with people and say, look, they're here, they want to work with us, how do we do this, how do we bridge the gap to make it work for both of us. And so if people are having issues, if they're having problems, that's why Delta has, you know, contracted with me. So if, you know, I'd be more than happy to help.
So, you know, like I said, for 20, 25 years, parents have been raising their kids around here to leave. They know they have to go somewhere to find opportunity or further their education. That's it's a culture. Mm-hmm. And then also a parent or the kids, they grew up the same way. They know that once they graduate from high school, that's it for them here. You know, there's really no jobs here. There's no education. Mm-hmm. So you start thinking that young, and then pretty soon, it's just the way it is. We want to reverse that. Mm-hmm. We want to make it to where people start thinking about how they can reinvest here, how they can grow up here, graduate from high school here, create jobs here, and reinvest back in our communities. Mm-hmm. It's extremely important that we tackle this, because it has a great deal to do with our economy as well.
So do you think moving forward with these classes is going to help job opportunities for people to actually want to stay here? Because after, you know, after getting classes and education and everything, then there's the whole aspect on trying to get a job. So do you think that it will help, you know, open up more opportunities and, you know, get people to stay here?
I think so. You know, think of it this way. It's hard to find a teacher up here or a person that wants to instruct in college, right? Mm-hmm. Because they don't, in the past, gee, I don't have a job next year because we don't know, it's uncertain. Mm-hmm. But if we have a consistent program and people know they can get their education here consistently, and teachers know or instructors know that they can teach year after year, they stay here. They come mm-hmm. here and they stay here. Mm-hmm. And then maybe people will come from out of the area, they'll come here.
Well, very true.
Services, food, clothing, mm-hmm. you know, all the things that you need for support of all of that.
You got a good point. I think it's going to open up so many opportunities and doors for this community. I think it's been great. Besides my view on the outcomes and, you know, the positives in this whole thing, what are some things that you think are going to come out of it positively, you know, throughout the whole ongoing process of getting the classes here? What are some positive things that you see coming out of it for our community?
We will have a workforce, an educated workforce. That's huge. And we can, I think then when Cliff gets the phone call for businesses coming in, you know, we can say, yeah, we have an educated workforce. We're ready to go. And I think it's just going to be up from here.
It's one of the first things a company asks when they call and they say, hey, you know, we want to come to Calaveras County. We have a business. We'd like to open up. Do you have an educated workforce? And I know we have, you know, a lot
intelligent of intelligent people.
Well, we do. We have a lot of smart people, but 6,000 of them are commuting somewhere else to go to work.
Yeah.
It's really hard to quantify or even, tell somebody, yes, we have an educated workforce. There's no real data behind that.
I hear you. So. My dad's always out of town with his job. If he could work up here, that'd be great.
Yeah.
But that's just not the case.
Stop
at the
commute.
Moment.
That's what, you know, that would be part of it. Mm-hmm. The other thing is, I think is really important, is the families get to stay together a little bit longer. There's many people that live up here that can't afford to send their kids down anywhere and go to college or, you know, go stay somewhere else. Mm-hmm. So they just don't. And then we end up with a lot of folks that are a little bit without choices. Mm-hmm. And so this hopefully will be able to provide families to be able to stay together a little longer, save them some money, and give them some choices.
It would honestly be so much more realistic to offer the classes up here because then you don't have to, you know, have a job so you can commute from the college to there, and it's going to be fantastic. So I want to just cover a little bit on when the classes start, when do they have to be enrolled by, and
yes,
things like that.
Yes, I can give that information
all
to
right.
you. So online enrollment has already opened. Mm-hmm. It opened July 21st, and it closes on August 14th.
Okay, so about a month left.
Okay. So we have time to do that. And then after August 18th, you still have a couple of weeks of when school starts on August 18th to add the class. So there's still plenty of time for you to get going and get it and add or drop any of your classes. So we have lots of time.
Good to hear. And I heard that, you know, you're still trying to fill those classes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And how many people per class do you think? I mean, what are you trying to get?
Well, we'd like to get as many as we can, but I think that, you know, if we had 20, 30 per class would be fabulous.
What classes do you see you guys offering in the future, I mean, years from now?
I would say general ed for sure.
Yeah.
But I'd like to see a more trade. It's about mm-hmm. 60% of the kids or people that graduate from high school, they're interested in trade, you know. Some school isn't for everybody, but we do want intelligent workers, you know, smart people. They got to learn how to run a business if they want to be an entrepreneur. So I'd like to see entrepreneur classes up here. What I'd like to see is people call in, and they can call my number, 612-8938. Sherry doesn't, what's your phone number, Sherry?
986-3413.
And let us know what they would like here.
Mm-hmm.
I see fire science. We can do that. If we, we collaborate with Columbia. Police science. I talked to the sheriff. Sheriff says, you know, we can make arrangements to have some classes in the meeting rooms maybe that they have up there. So we have the resources. Mm-hmm. We just need to put the programs together, and we have the right person to do that. That's Sherry.
Well, that's great to hear. I would love to see communications, journalism, broadcasting. I mean, that's what I'm into. So if I don't have to move away, I mean,
great.
Awesome, right?
Hey, you know, just
I'd love
call
to keep
one
you
of
here.
Call one of those numbers and make that suggestion.
That'd be great.
So what is the age limit? Am I too young to do it?
No.
Are you sure?
Is that what you want to do in your future?
You mean as far as classes? Are you talking about classes?
Classes. No, I'm not too young to do it. I'm doing it right now. But yeah, classes. Is there age limits? I mean, can adults obviously can do it still too.
I don't know for sure, but I believe it's 17.
17.
Yeah.
I mean, one more year. What the heck, man? All right. Is there anything else on this that you would, about, what about the cost and everything? Do you want to kind of cover that a little bit? Is it the same as going to the actual college and everything?
It's the same as going to the actual college. Yeah. Yeah. So it's just, you know, they have on the flyer here that we've put in the Calaveras. This actually has gone out in the Valley Springs News.
Okay.
And they've also done some, paid for advertisement in the Calaveras Enterprise, so we have tried to make sure that people get it out. I also had it available at our roundup at the high school and also at the Warrior Welcome at Toyon. So just trying to, you know, get it out there so people know that it's there and we're offering it. But it does state on here that it's only $46 per unit, so that's pretty good.
That's not bad.
It's worth it.
At all.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely agree. What are some things that Delta College has said about the whole collabing and everything like that?
They're excited. And, you know, everybody I've talked to over there who I'm in process of training. So, but they're warm, they're welcoming, they're excited. Whatever I need, they want to make sure that they're here. They're planning on coming to, you know, talk to back to school night at the high school, the college nights that we do, and just really trying to get out in the community. So we really want to do that. We want to go to the Board of Supervisor meetings, to the Calaveras Unified School Board meetings, and just really let people know that Delta is here and we want to build the program.
I've always thought that, you know, Sonora would be a realistic kind of thing because, I mean, it's not that far. But I'm glad that you guys are going to be collaborating with them and everything. And what did Sonora say, like, they wanted to do with
They're
you guys?
So excited to work with
so
us, too.
So they're going to collaborate, too.
Yeah. And I think there's enough that we can all work together.
So, you know, it's about education and how to provide the education at the most economical way for the schools are having a tough time with funding, you know, nowadays. And so, but we want to get our biggest bang for our buck. You know, people pay that hard-earned tax money, and it was going away for a long time, almost 8 years, without any return. And so here's our opportunity, but we need help from the people that live here by engaging in this process and helping us build this program. It's extremely important for our future of the county. And, you know, it's going to help our economy. It's going to help families stay together. We said that already. It's just all positive. There's nothing negative about it that I could think of.
Well, besides people signing up for the classes, obviously that's going to help a lot with the whole process. But what else could the community get on, you know, engage in the process and to really be a part of everything that's going on? What are some things that they could do?
They can attend all of the, Terry Tanner, was a part of when the counselors came up to help the students from last year go into Delta, and so they can get involved in that. You know, go to everything that you can think that you can see, pay attention to the news, you know, the media, and go to everything that you can see when it has to do with our education here in Calaveras County.
And call if they want input or if they have questions or, you know, be involved.
Call. Give suggestions, you know, everything you can.
Is there anything that you'd want the public to be aware of that's going on or anything? Is there anything in particular?
I would say that, you know, if we don't respond to this and put people in these classes, then we probably won't have the opportunity very long. So, you know, even though we pay all this money, it's going to have to, if it didn't go to Delta, it would go somewhere else. So, like Amador County, they don't have a college district, but they still pay to the state chancellor's office. So, we really need to take advantage of this. This is an opportunity for us.
correct me if I'm wrong, but what is the post-secondary education going to look like?
Well, it does. It's just college classes, basically. So we're building a junior college level courses here and certifications so that people can actually then get their education or certifications here.
Okay. And have you gotten good feedback from the people of the community about the classes and everything?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we had a press conference on July 11th.
Yeah.
It was on Friday, July 11th at the library. And there was probably 50 people that showed up for that. You were there, remember?
I sure was. You made me go up in front of everybody.
But you were late. You were late, though.
Hold on right there. Let me explain myself. No, my mom had a headache, so I ran all the way to the library to be there for you.
Thank you. Right. So it was a good turnout. Kathy Hart was there with Steve Castellanos, our college. He's on the college board. He's our representative for Calaveras County. Sherry was there. John Garamendi Jr. was there, who helped us a lot.
Tremendously.
Yeah, he went to every meeting that we went to. We also visited legislators, to ask for their support.
So what was the experience like going up in front of them and explaining your views?
Well, it's kind of like walking into a hallway and then you get let in a door and everything's in a hurry. Mm-hmm. Some of them are pretty good size offices.
Was it just you or did Sherry go as well?
Sherry's been right there, man. Are you kidding me? She made all the appointments.
They're no different than we are. They were excited that we would go to them. We went to the Senator, Kathleen Galgiani, who, she's a lovely lady, who we wanted, because she represents Stockton, mm-hmm. We wanted to make sure that she knew that we wanted to be a part of Delta. And then we went to, I took Cliff to the Capitol.
Mm-hmm. First
and,
time.
And we went to Assemblymember Susan Eggman's office. Mm-hmm. And she's a very smart lady. She's from Calaveras, so that was nice. And so we had some time to sit down and chat with her, which was really good. So
she was actually raised in West Point.
Yeah.
Small world. So she understands the challenges that we have up here.
So it's just getting them involved and sitting down with them. And our assembly member, Frank Bigelow, has been a huge help.
Dana Jorgensen, his aide, has been at every meeting.
Yep.
We have a lot of folks in the community that helped us out on our committee. We have Dave Tanner, Terry Tanner, Grant Barrett. He's running for judge. His wife, Jan Barrett, who actually taught for Delta at the hospitals when there was a nursing program there. And then there's Zero McDaniels, Mark Campbell. Who else is on there? You? And Dana Jorgensen.
And
John Garamendi Jr. So it was a motivated group that we were thinking about education. And that's what we need to think about here.
Mm-hmm. I thought speaking in front of Cliff and the Board of Supervisors was big and out. No, it was. No, but I mean, speaking in front of a legislator and stuff like that, that's a lot, you guys. Next, you're going to be going to the president and stuff, you know?
I doubt it. Well, Susan Eggman, I was a little bit nervous around because she's very focused, but Senator Galgiani, I actually was in Rotary with her when she was an aide.
Oh,
so
cool.
She was, just a young gal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's impressive. Sure, impressive. Is there anything else that you guys would like to cover? I mean, as far as the Delta classes go and everything.
No, I just encourage people to enroll.
Enroll.
Please go. Please attend. And, for any of the high school seniors who just graduated, mm-hmm. they're not sure what they want to do, I would just encourage you to get in those courses and help us out, help you out, so that you don't have to commute so far.
Yeah, save the money. One of the things that a small town thinking is, gee, I can't wait to get out of here. But I got to tell you, some people, they're going to leave, but this is a beautiful place.
Sure is.
Yeah,
sure.
You got to remember, if you live down there, you come up here to go on vacation. So why not just stay?
Yeah.
And get educated, reinvest back in your communities, make mm-hmm. this a better place. That's what we want to do. We want to build our county into like the best county in California, right? Mm-hmm. We have all the tools. We just need to put them together and make them work.
And what would you like to say to the people who are watching or who are going to see this to just inspire them and to motivate them to, you know, go and apply for these classes and anything like that?
You know, I would just like to say, you know, too, we have a great population of people who, like Cliff, who are not very tech, you know, need that tech part. So we'd love to fill that computer science class. I mean, they're going to talk about just basic stuff, you know, teach you kind of brush up on Word and that kind of stuff. So it would be a great class to start. The political science, if you like history, you know, please come in and do it. The English classes, you know, if you need them, if you're just getting started or if you would like to get an AA degree, you know, we just would like to fill those classes. Would be a fabulous start.
And I think two of those classes, the English 1A and the social science, are transferable. Mm-hmm. So, that can go toward, if you're going to go to a four-year, you can take it with you. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be good. We need to make it really good.
Yeah. Is there any more meetings coming up to discuss kind of the outlook, or was it just that one at the library? Is there any more?
We don't have anything scheduled.
No,
yet.
I don't think so. We'll continue to meet as a committee, just to kind of keep an eye on things. But as far as Delta goes, it's going to be Sherry. She's got the show. she can rely on me for support. There's no doubt about that, and I'm sure she'll build her own support group. If you want to get involved in that, give her a call. You know, there's possibilities for that, but. She's got quite a job on her hands right here, I got to tell you.
I do want to thank that we've had several people contact me just from the community, different is it CalWORKS? Mm-hmm. And just different human resources type stuff that deal with a lot of different aspects of our community. Mm-hmm. And they've, you know, how can we get involved? What can we do? You know, we help people get jobs. We do a lot of stuff. And so it can't wait. They are very excited to get started.
How does it feel to fill those big shoes you got? I'm just kidding.
It'll be good.
Definitely. Well, thank you guys so much for being on the show. I really enjoyed hearing everything about Delta classes.
Us.
If we can go ahead and put the numbers up again and the Delta thing, that'd be great. So it's deltacollege.edu, and it is, whose number is that?
Who is number? Which one?
Oh. It's yours.
That's Delta's.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Are you, like, really? They're just going to call Delta? I hate Delta.
My number's on there, too, but that's Delta.
Okay, so fine. Delta's number is 209-954-5151. I thought I was just having deja vu for a second. I'm just kidding. Okay, guys, well, thank you so much for watching Shasta's Teen Journal, and I hope you guys enjoyed the show. And if you guys need any more information, please contact Sherry or Cliff, or go ahead and go on that website and sign up for those classes, because they do need to be filled, and you'll definitely be seeing very positive outcomes of offering these classes in our county. And if you guys want any more information on Shasta's Teen Journal, we also have a Facebook page and an Instagram, and go check out www.shastateenjournal.weebly.com for more updates and information, and we'll see you next time on another episode. Bye!